Good afternoon. My name is Howard Tipton, and I serve as the St. Lucie County Administrator. With me today is Public Safety Director Ron Parrish, as well as St. Lucie County Administrator for our Health Department, Clint Sperber. This is our Hurricane ISAIAS briefing at 6:15 on July 31st, and it is hard to imagine that we are talking about a storm event on July 31st. It's just kind of been the way 2020's going so far. But we roll with it, right? We don't get to determine the cards that were dealt. We just get to figure out how we play them. And so we're playing this one. I want to talk a little bit about the current track. Currently, the hurricane continues its approach towards the Sunshine State with expectations it will begin riding up the coast Saturday afternoon with winds increasing up to 75 miles an hour, making ISAIAS a Category 1 hurricane. Currently, St. Lucie, Martin, and Indian River counties are under a hurricane warning and tropical storm warning. That means a warning is different from a watch. That means that these types of winds and these kinds of impacts are likely. ISAIAS was officially designated a Category 1 storm by the National Hurricane Center just after midnight last night, but it is projected to reach a Category 2 strength storm early this evening or early Saturday as it passes over the Bahamas before dying back down ahead of its brush with Florida. As of 5 p.m., the update, it is 375 miles southeast of Miami, moving up northwest at 15 miles an hour. So it was moving a little bit faster. It was at 20 miles an hour at one time. 15 is still a pretty good moving storm, and so we'll take that as compared to some of the other storms that we saw, like last year, Dorian, where it basically didn't move for a couple of days. While the storm center is not predicted to make Florida landfall, the hurricane force winds extend 35 miles from its core, and its tropical storm force winds can reach up to 205 miles. Now remember, when we talk about forecasts can move. On Monday, remember, this storm was on the left side of the state. It was going up the left side of the state. So in this period of time, it has changed now. Now as we get closer to the actual event, forecasts become much more accurate, but this can still move east or it can move west. And we've seen that happen with Matthew, we've seen it happen with Irma. And so we just have to be ready. So you want to govern your activities accordingly. The gusts that we anticipate are anywhere from 55 to 75 miles an hour, and the storm surge is anywhere from 1 to 3 feet. As a result of all of this and the anticipation of the storm event, St. Lucie County will be going to a local declaration of emergency beginning tomorrow. And we will increase our level of activation. We are currently at a level of activation 2 for the COVID-19 response at the Emergency Operations Center. We will take that to a level 1 response starting at noon tomorrow. So protective actions that we would like to take before the storm comes. Make sure that you have all the necessary supplies. Have plenty of batteries, including batteries or chargers for your cell phones. If you have shutters, now would be a good time to put those up. Not everybody does, but to the extent that you can make sure you're looking around your house, taking any of the patio furniture, anything that, you know, can be light in a wind that could cause damage, let's make sure that those are secured. This is the time to do that. This storm for our area will be coming in, and we'll start to see the real impacts of these winds tomorrow evening, early potentially. And so we want to make sure that we get all this work done well in advance. So that's very important. Trimming of trees. So this is not the time to start trimming trees. This is not the time to put vegetative material out by the street. This is the time to not trim trees. And if you have vegetative material that you've already trimmed, you need to move that back into your yard. You need to move that back into the backyard or under some kind of cover, if at all possible. We do not have time to pick it up before this storm event happens. We will have regular trash service tomorrow through the day, as we would normally do on Saturday, if that's your pickup day. But we do not have time to do the extra pickups that many of the debris trimming activities require. So please, it becomes a projectile for your neighborhood. It becomes something that we don't need to see flying around. So please, for your neighbor's sake, for your own sake, Let's move that stuff off the street and let's move it back into your yard undercover. If you have a boat, this is the time to make sure that it is secured. So make sure you've got some extra lines. Make sure if it's in dry storage that you have that contained and wrapped up as well. So that's important. Boats and storms, usually not a good combination if you're not prepared. Again, as I mentioned, prepare your home as you would for a storm event, just making sure that anything loose and lying around is picked up. Our next briefing will be at noon tomorrow. We encourage you to follow your local news reports. Tune into briefings on your local TV or radio stations or on social media or at stluceco.gov/hurricane for more information. Now, mentioned the COVID-19. We are still in the middle of this pandemic, as our other briefings have shared. And so I want to make sure that if you are going to be out and about, the face mask ordinance or face covering ordinance is still in effect. And so it's important if you're going to be out and about, if you're going to a Home Depot or Publix or wherever you're at, make sure that you continue to wear your face coverings. The other thing is we want to talk a little bit about sheltering. We at this point have no plans to open up a shelter based on the storm's current track. And so what that means is that we want you to shelter in place or with family and friends or wherever you might feel safe. But if you're going to go and shelter with family or friends, make sure and understand that the social distancing needs to take place. You need to remember to do that. That's important. I know if I was going to go up to Orlando and stay with some friends up there, I may not know where they've been or what they've been up to. And so to protect myself or to protect them, I'm going to wear my face covering and I'm going to make sure that while I'm in that house, I'm going to social distance. So please, please do that. So that's on the issue of shelters. Now, if the storm does change overnight, we will be back and issuing additional direction. But at this point, I just want to emphasize we're not anticipating opening shelters at this time. Our transit service, St. Lucie County Paratransit will be performing services from 7 a.m. to 12 p.m. And the fixed route will be providing services from 8 a.m. to 12 p.m. The dialysis trips that have already been scheduled will run as normal, and there are no changes to those times. Our information line, St. Lucie County's Emergency Operations Center, is currently at a level 2 or partial activation. As I mentioned, we will be going to a level 1 tomorrow at noon. Our public information line is 772-460-HELP or 460-4357. And we will be opening that up at 8 a.m. Tomorrow, and it will remain open until 6 p.m. tomorrow. Residents with questions are urged to call the helpline, or if you need to, call 911. Post-storm, as with any activity, and we're kind of, we were joking earlier that with a storm event like this, at least the emergency, event comes and then it goes, unlike COVID-19. And so we can actually think about this post-storm event, which is kind of something to look forward to. But as always, remember that there could be down power lines. There could be submerged water. If you are driving somewhere and you see a road that is covered with water, don't try to go through it. You have no idea how deep it is. And so we want to make sure that we're careful like we always are as we're emerging from a post-event. That we take care to look out for those types of things. Additionally, I mentioned that you might have down power lines, which means you wouldn't have power. Some people are starting up generators. It's great to exercise your generator. It's good to make sure that it's ready to go, but please do not move it inside, and please do not move it into your garage. Those fumes can go through the house, and we have had examples of just recent hurricanes where we have lost some of our citizens because they have died from asphyxiation. We don't want to see that. It is, it's amazing that we can get through the storm and then lose somebody, and we never want to do that. So please, please watch your generators very carefully. St. Lucie County Parks and Recreation Department has canceled its public programs on Saturday and Sunday, including all three county pools, which is Ravenwood, Lakewood Park, and Lincoln Park, and the St. Lucie County Aquarium and Regional History Centers are also closed this weekend. All St. Lucie County libraries will provide curbside pickup from 10 a.m. to noon. The Kilmer Library in Fort Pierce and the Lewis Library in Port St. Lucie libraries will be open from 10 a.m. to noon as well for in-person visits. Even though you may want to go to the beach this weekend to see the waves, and this is going to be quite an event for our shoreline, we do not recommend at all going into the water. We are currently not anticipating any type of an evacuation order or closing off the barrier islands. However, I understand how the beaches can be an attraction. Please, please do not go down to the beaches, and please do not get into the water. With waves that are going to be pounding, you can be swept away in the blink of an eye, and there are unguarded beaches at this time. There's nobody there to save you, so please stay out of the water. With that, we say thank you for your time this evening and ask you to be safe. Make sure you're checking on your neighbors, and if there are any questions, we're happy to answer them.
Yeah, there was just one question on Facebook about evacuations, but I think you answered that. At this time, we're not issuing any mandatory evacuations.
Yeah, we're looking at the storm surge. We're looking at the wind bands, and we at this point, we're not anticipating any evacuation. So with that, we thank you very much for your time, and we will now turn this over and do our briefing in Creole. So thank you very much.
Bonsoir, Pepe Haïtien. En Playa Sécurité Publique, St. Lucie County, a contrôlé cyclone ISAIAS. Qui espère être sous côte Floride, qui a affecté côte Trésor avec vent tempête tropicale avec la pluie samedi soir jusqu'à dimanche matin. Mais il y a une possibilité que les conditions cyclonales qui ont affecté la région si la tempête a approché plus près de côte l'Est. En plan de gestion IJAN, St. Lucie County a demandé aux résidents chercher refuge et puis rester en place pendant le cyclone ça a passé. Nous beaucoup gain aucun plan pour nous ouvrir abri au soir by l'ordre évacuation. La pluie qui arrive jusqu'à 5 pouces. Nous espérons la pluie a tomber plus fort dans Georges Cosla. Temps pour changer, pas conduire dans l'eau qui trempe. Division code conformité de St. Lucie County a demandé tout site construction active pour sécuriser débris, fatras, équipements et matériaux pour construction avant tempête l'arrivée. En plus de ça, candidats politiques doivent retirer toutes ces politiques. Département récréation et Parc Saint-Lucie annulé programme public qui a fait samedi et dimanche dans la piscine Ravenwood, Lakewood Park, Lincoln Park avec aquarium et centre histoire régionale de Saint-Lucie. S'il vous plaît, tout résident Saint-Lucie County, pas mettez gros piles de débris sous bord route là jusqu'à après tempête la fin passée. Centre opération IJAN de Saint-Lucie County retenait non yon parti numéro 2 activation. La privée yon numéro 1 activation demain. Ligne information publique là c'est 772 460 43 57. La ouvri samedi 1er août 8 a.m. jusqu'à 6 p.m. Merci beaucoup.